Tailwind CSS is a very popular CSS utility-based framework that allows us to easily add classes that essentially almost one-to-one represent underlying CSS styling. So for our example, if we wanted our h1 to be blue, we could add a class to it called textBlue500 or some variant there within, and our text would automatically be blue because Tailwind CSS will provide that styling for us. It also comes with its own configuration file that allows us to define what exactly we want those utilities to be, and it allows us to customize our coloring as we see fit. So to start with, we're going to need to get it installed. So let's go to our terminal here, and let's go ahead and stop our server by holding Control and hitting C, and then let's clear out our terminal. So first and foremost, we're going to want to do npm install to install the dependencies. We're going to do -D to specify that this is a dev dependency. This is really just a shorthand for --save-dev. So either of those two would work here. And then we want to install the Tailwind CSS package. So Tailwind CSS actually has a dependency of PostCSS, so we're going to need to install that as well. If you're not familiar with it, it's similar to SAS, if you happen to be familiar with that. At the end of the day, it's just going to add additional functionality on top of our underlying CSS. Whenever we compile it, it will take it all down to vanilla CSS so that we can make use of it. So let's go ahead and install PostCSS here as well. And then lastly, let's use AutoPrefixer. AutoPrefixer is a PostCSS utility. It's going to essentially add in vendor or browser prefixes where they're needed inside of our CSS to make it fully browser compliant. So let's go ahead and install those. Cool, let's clear our browser. And we can have Tailwind CSS inject its command into our project by running npx tailwind css init -p. npx allows us to run commands from packages without necessarily having to have them installed directly from the npm repository. And here we're specifically running Tailwind CSS init, and this in particular will add in the Tailwind CSS configuration file. And the -p is also going to add in the PostCSS configuration file so that we can actually tell PostCSS to use Tailwind CSS as well as AutoPrefixer. So let's go ahead and run this. And you should see it create a Tailwind CSS configuration file called tailwind.config.js. And it also created for us a PostCSS configuration file called postcss.config.js. Cool, so let's open back up our project. And if we scroll down, we should see two new files within our project structure: PostCSS config.js and Tailwind CSS config.js. Within the Tailwind configuration, we can alter our theme, add an additional Tailwind CSS plugins, and it also comes with a utility called Purge CSS, which will streamline any Tailwind CSS utilities down to just those that we're using within our project whenever we build this out for production, keeping our CSS file nice and streamlined. In order for Purge CSS to work though, within this array, we need to provide a file path to all of the applicable files that it should check for our CSS usages. So for this, we'll do a string, and let's point it to our resources, any folder inside of resources, and any file inside of resources, but we can specifically tailor this to those that end in Edge, JavaScript, TypeScript, and then if you happen to use it, JSX or TSX or even Vue. So within our resources directory, it will look inside of any folder within there and any file within any folders that end in Edge, JavaScript, TypeScript, JSX, TSX, and Vue. Any styles that it finds within any of those matching files, it will leave into our final CSS file whenever we build it for production. So we can give this a save. Next, let's take a look at our new PostCSS configuration file. And you see it has Tailwind CSS and AutoPrefixer automatically within here. So we should be A-OK to go on this front. I do want to note that you want AutoPrefixer to be after Tailwind CSS though, as that will allow AutoPrefixer to add in any vendor or browser prefixes to the underlying Tailwind CSS classes that we make use of. So since we have Tailwind CSS first, PostCSS will run Tailwind CSS first, and then it will provide AutoPrefixer the result after it runs Tailwind CSS. So the ordering here does matter. Cool, so now the last thing that we should need to do is scroll on up to our app.css file and add in the Tailwind declarations. So at the top of our file here, we can do @tailwind_base. This is essentially like a CSS reset. So it will make our H1 the same size as paragraph text and remove all of the button styles and all that fun stuff. So it's basically a CSS reset. Then we'll want to do tailwind and add in their components. And lastly, their utilities. So tailwind and utilities. Let's finally scroll down to our H1. And let's remove our blue coloring, give this file a save. We should now be able to jump back into our homepage, and let's scroll down to that H1 and let's add in the class of text. And we'll make this one red so that we can easily tell that the change did pick up within our CSS file and that Tailwind CSS is actually working. And we'll set this to the 500 variant of the red coloring. Let's give that a save. We do need to jump back into our terminal and boot our server back up so we can run npm run dev here. Once that boots up, we're A-OK to jump back into our browser. Cool, so we can see a definite change happened here. Everything pretty much looks the exact same, regardless if it's a link, an H1, or paragraph text. That's that Tailwind CSS reset taking place, getting rid of all of the browser's default styling. So let's head into our homepage because that's where we added in the text coloring. And voila, we see it works and it's in a nice red. So now we know that we have Tailwind CSS working. Let's go ahead and get rid of our browser console. And let's add in a couple of classes just to make this a little bit easier on the eyes. So let's hide our browser back away, jump back into our text editor. Let's take all of our page contents and let's cut that out and let's wrap it in a div with a class. Let's set this to a max width of 3XL and let's center it by doing MX auto. And we can paste our page contents back in and give it a nice indent. Let's also add some spacing around this as well. So let's do margin top, let's say something like 6. So we should be able to give this a save, jump back into our browser, and there we go. So that's a little bit easier on the eyes. It's more centered, not tucked away all the way up here in our top left corner, and it's not starting right with the top of the browser tab. We'll want to do the exact same thing on our movie pages here as well. So let's go ahead and take care of that. We also don't want our H1 to actually be red. So let's also get rid of that there too. Give that a save and let's copy this div. Jump over to our show page and we can paste the div right inside of our body and wrap everything inside of that div. Give everything inside of the div an indent, give it a save. Let's jump back into our browser and now our movie page looks a little bit better there too. Let's go ahead and add in a styling specifically for our headings so that they actually behave like headings. So for this, we don't actually need to add in classes. We can jump into our CSS file and make that a global change. So let's do that. So within our CSS file, we can do, let me scroll down here a little bit. Let's do H1. And we can either type this out manually as we are up here with the HTML and body styles, or we can actually use Tailwind CSS and inject it inside of this H1 styling. We can do that by doing @apply. And now all that we need to do is reference the Tailwind CSS class that we want to apply specifically to this element. So for example, we could do text 3XL, give this a save. And now if we jump back into our browser, our H1 is nice and large. Let's also bold it and give it some spacing. So we can do font bold, margin bottom 3, and maybe margin top 6. Give that a save, jump back into our browser, and now that's looking more like a heading. Cool. And we can verify that that change happened globally by jumping into our homepage, where our heading looks like a heading there as well.